Hello everyone, this is Justin, an application specialist at Roctek International. Today we'll be going over how to input the basic building blocks of any takeoff. Let's jump right in. To start, we'll use the most basic measurement of any 3D takeoff, the contour line. We'll head to the grading measurements, select contours, choose whether or not we want to use an existing or proposed, find an elevation to start with, and select OK. From here, the cursor will change back to the pencil, letting us know that we can use the left mouse button to draw. We'll go ahead and zoom in, but you'll notice we don't quite get as far over as we'd like. To move the screen, we can use the hand mode, located in navigation, to left click and drag the screen. Next, to switch back, we can either toggle it again, or if your mouse has a scroll wheel, you can press it as if it were another button to switch back to drawing mode. Now, left click, hold, and drag the mouse along the existing contour line. Next, we want to enter in another topo, so we'll select new elevation, type out 25, and start from the beginning of the 25 topo. Left click, hold, and drag the mouse along the line. We could select new topo again to do the 20. However, we've already established an elevation interval. Instead, we can just click next elevation, and we can see at the top that is in fact doing the 20-foot existing topo. Again, left click, hold, and drag. And when necessary, pan the screen to move it. Let's go ahead and fast forward through the rest of these topos. Don't forget that if you make a mistake, you can press the backspace button to go back. Also, once you finish the existing topos, select the finish button, enter the new contours, and select propose and finish those as well. Go ahead and pause the video and restart when you're ready. Now that we have our topos entered, it's time to move on to the four major regions displayed. We have a driveway, a parking lot, a pad, and a do not disturb area. To start the driveway, let's head to the measurements tab, select work region, region with subgrades, give it a name, and if you like, you can also change the color. From here, we'll draw the perimeter the same way we did the topos earlier. Single left clicks for straightaways, or left click, hold, and drag to engage line tracker. Remember, if you make a mistake, you can backspace and redraw. Once that's finished, head to the finish button. And from here, we can make adjustments to this area. For instance, to enter in a subgrade, we'll head to the subgrades and balancing tab. Select the proposed subgrade materials, add, and pull asphalt and crush stone from our drop-down menu. This will allow us to adjust the grades down to handle cut and fill, and to give us a surface area and volume of these two materials. Next, use the work region again to draw the parking lot for a region with subgrades. Also, use the do not disturb region, and use the pad routine for the pad. When entering the elevation for the pad, be sure to put 13.5, the final floor elevation. We'll adjust that grade down with the proposed subgrades, such as concrete and crushed stone. This concludes part one of the basic inputs. Please stick around to finish up part two and complete the takeoff.